So we will start with our session now. And as usual, we will start with our posture. So you can be sitting on the chair or on the cushion. If on the cushion, then you can be sitting either cross-legged, half lotus or full lotus posture. If on the chair, we make sure our feet are well grounded and our body well balanced. Our back straight and relaxed, not too tight, not too hunched. We have to find the right balance for ourselves, somewhere in between these two extremes. Our eyes can be either partially open or fully closed. If you are too sleepy or dull, we can keep them partially open to let some of the light in. If you are too agitated, if you are too all over the place, then we can keep them closed. Our tongue resting on the upper palate to avoid excessive secretion of saliva. And our neck slightly tilted towards the ground. Hands resting on the knees or on the lap. If they're on the lap, then our right hand cupped into our left hand and thumbs gently touching each other. And let's spend some time with our body. So our awareness can be somewhere, anywhere inside our body, but here right now in the present moment. And as we are settling our body and mind, we also try and relax our body. A good way to do is to scan our body from top of the head to the all the way down to the feet. So we go through different parts of our body and try and relax every single part. So we can start with our top of the head, try and relax it fully. Forehead, eyes and eyebrows. Fully relaxed. And our entire face. shoulders and neck. Arms and elbows fully relaxed. Forearms, wrists, and our hands. All the fingers in our hands fully relaxed. Chest and abdomen. Let them be. And also our back. All the muscles fully relaxed. As we are relaxing our body, it's important to also have a vigilant mind, mind which is aware, mind which is present in the moment. So just like we've relaxed our body, we also try and release any tension or agitation, any thoughts that we might have in our mind. And we can use our breath, the out-breath, to release all of it. Try and release all these things that we might have in our mind. To complete this preparation of body and mind, we can use 3 deep breaths. So breathe all the way in and breathe all the way out, relaxing any remaining tension in our body and mind. And once you're done, you can set the motivation for this practice. So in our own words, we can think about why we are here again today, meditating. How is it going to benefit us and people around us? So in our own words, we set the motivation for this practice today. Try and extend this motivation to neutral beings, people we don't often interact with, but we see them on the roads or in the park, in the market maybe. So you just set the motivation for them as well. Check how this practice is going to help them also. Once you're ready, we can go to our actual practice. So once again, we can use our breath as our anchor point. We can feel the rise and fall of abdomen as we breathe in and out. So you can go with that as an anchor point, or we can go with the entrance of our nostrils. You can feel the sensation of breath as you breathe in and out at the entrance of our nostrils. Whatever anchor point we choose, we make sure we stick to it. And when we get distracted, we bring ourselves back. So we meditate like this for the next 15 minutes. If we notice we are distracted, we bring ourselves back to the breath. If we are distracted, we can gently bring ourselves back to our breath. For the last part of this practice, let's bring ourselves back again to our breath. Just a couple more minutes. Okay, we can Gently come out of our meditation. Open our eyes. And come back into our surroundings. It doesn't have to be in an abrupt way. We can take our time. Enjoy this meditative equipoise, this sense of awareness that we have generated. And as usual, we'll end our practice with a dedication prayer by Bodhisattva Shantideva from his book Bodhicharya Avatar. And as we go through this dedication prayer, we can also dedicate to people who are suffering or have suffered in the recent past, people who have passed away recently, and also dedicate to people who are suffering because of the war in Ukraine, and people who are suffering because of the natural calamities, climate change. May all beings everywhere take by sufferings of body and mind, obtain an ocean of happiness and joy by virtue of my merits. May no living creature suffer, commit evil, or ever fall ill. May no one be afraid or belittled with the mind weighed down by depression. May the blind see forms and the deaf hear sounds. May those whose bodies are worn with toil be restored on finding repose. May the naked find clothing, the hungry find food. May the thirsty find water and delicious drinks. May the poor find wealth, those weak with sorrow find joy. May the hopeless find hope, constant happiness and prosperity. May there be timely rains and bountiful harvests. May all the medicines be effective and wholesome prayers bear fruit. May all who are sick and ill quickly be freed from their ailments. Whatever diseases there are in the world, may they never occur again. May the frightened cease to be afraid and those bound with greed. May the powerless find power and people think of benefiting each other. For as long as space remains, for as long as sentient beings remain, until then may I too remain to dispel the mysteries of the world. Okay, thank you everyone for joining, and I'll hopefully see some of you on Monday. Take care, have a good weekend. Bye-bye.